Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. We decided to keep Don D.C. Curry around a little longer. Bring him over to the table. To get his take on what's going on in the world today, and what better man to give us a very unique perspective.
You're right about that.
I know I am.
Well, I'm dying to know this perspective. Look here, DC. Now, there has been a debate down to the world, to the Instagram and to everywhere, about the king of R&B on social media. Now, first of all, who do you think is the current king of R&B?
That's easy. Bobby Brown.
Okay. In the words of Whitney,
how about that?
It's his prerogative.
I'm officially old, because when that debate started the other day, the other people they were arguing about, I didn't even know who they were.
Bobby Brown, man, what's going on?
Right. What about the king of comedy? Outside of yourself, who would you give that crown to?
Well, first, I'm nowhere near the king of comedy. And it depends on how you look at it, because if you look at king within having the most appeal to the most different, the vast amount of people, you have to be compromising, and I'm not compromising. Okay. I'll never be a host for anything.
Oh, thank you. That is an amazing segue.
No, I'll never be the host for
right.
anything. Because I have offended at some point.
Everybody. So let's talk a little bit about the whole Kevin Hart. And of course, he was slated to host the Academy Awards, and he had to step down. Your opinion, or he decided to step down, your opinion on him stepping down, should he even
done that.
Well, when you got that kind of money, it's your prerogative. To bum Bobby.
But that's what Bobby said.
I think this thing about apologizing from a comic standpoint.
Right.
I got no problem with a comic, even if he makes an offensive comment, if it's in an effort to be funny. The problem I had with was the richest boy that said the stuff at the improv.
Who that?
Was it Mike Richards?
I don't know.
He said stuff at the improv in Hollywood. Mike Richards. When you abandon your intent to be funny and your intent is to hurt somebody, then I got a problem.
Right.
If your intent is to be funny and you happen to hurt somebody, I got no problem. But you know, I have at some point offended everybody.
Everybody.
They talking about LGBTQ, which is 5 letters, ain't even 26 letters in the alphabet. So that's 20% right there that you would have to block off. And you know, come on, man. Take a joke. And I've heard gay people tell jokes about people that weren't gay.
Right.
So what's the difference?
Right. Well, with that being said, do you think that comedians should get a pass on being politically correct?
Well, if your desire, I'm a victim of low aspirations.
Okay, then.
But I'm not trying to appeal to everybody.
Right.
I'm not trying not to appeal to everybody, but I'm not going out of my way. So, you know, you do what suits you and what you want to do. If I wanted to appeal to the masses and everything, if I was so concerned with that, then I would probably make more adjustments than I make. But I already know I'll never host the Oscars or nothing. I'm too radical. I'm too opinionated. No hate. No hate for anybody.
Right, okay.
But no fear. No hate, but
that's
I got no fear.
Come on, that's a little piece of word, eh?
No hate, but no fear.
You know, we have Tiffany Haddish, who's coming out and just really doing her thing. Do you think that female comedians as a whole, do you think that they're getting their just due in the comedic world?
I think they're doing better than ever.
Okay.
You know, and I'm proud of them. I'm proud of people, period, for doing what they can do. I ain't mad at nobody. I think some people have taken a hit to make it that way. I'm proud of Monique, but I think she took a hit for speaking out. But you know, you either go with your heart or you just, you know, suck it up and do whatever. But I'm proud of Tiffany, you know. And people always argue, well, so-and-so is funnier than so-and-so, so-and-so is funnier. But it's not really all about that. You know, you got to be compromised. In a certain situation, it may have something to do. But in stand-up tonight, you know, I'll be doing the best I can.
You said the word compromising. So do you feel that Cat Williams was trying to say about Tiffany, do you kind of agree with that?
Cat my man.
Cat my man.
We played golf the other day and he was talking. Hey, you know, Cat kind of guy, he just in the middle of us, he be talking and saying something, and you just look at him, and to myself, I'm like, this boy is really crazy. Hey, Cat is my man, and Cat is crazy like a fox.
Okay.
That's all I'm gonna say.
You gonna leave it right there? Okay. Answer the question.
He's
okay.
Crazy
okay.
Like
you gonna
fox.
Leave it right there?
Well, go ahead. Okay. Mm-hmm. Well, speaking of Monique, why do you feel that when women speak up in any industry, not just comedy, but just any industry, because in the music business is the same kind of concepts? Mm-hmm. Why do we have to get called to be every time we voice our opinion, or a diva? Mm-hmm. Every time we voice our opinion,
or hard to work with.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I mean, what would you like to become?
Your name is good for starters. You know, just give me Selena. I'm good on Selena.
I'm not condoning it.
I'm just saying.
How about a woman with a voice? How about that? A woman with influence.
That's
a woman
not edgy enough.
Okay.
That's boring.
Oh, okay.
Well, now that you put it that way.
Well, yeah. We get it.
But you know what that's all about? That's all about tribal language to me, even when you come down to the N-word and all that. And people say, well, DC, why can't you say it? And I can't say it to my white friend. I said, because you're not in the tribe. Mm-hmm. So membership has its privileges.
Yeah. You know?
I'm saying that to say, I hear women call each other that all the time,
yes,
and it makes
true.
No difference.
That's true.
Mm-hmm. If you're black, there's a tribal language you can say to another black person. It makes no difference. If you're Jewish, there's some things you can say. If you are in the group,
right.
It's like credit card membership.
It's like a credit card.
Well, right. I'm gonna get that on my credit.
I like that.
Right on in the
corner. Don DC Curry, if you are in the Atlanta area, make sure you head over to the Uptown Comedy Corner all weekend long.
Yes.
And to find out when he's in your city, please follow him down to the social media at DC Curry. Can we give it up for Don DC?
Yeah.